Here is Xavier Wolf, senior, Memphis Central. Earlier today, he won the long jump competition.
Xavier Wolf of Memphis Central. He's one of only 42 jumpers all time to ever go over 50 feet in a triple jump. What more is there to get from that? I know he believes in his ability to go farther. So does his coaches.
The senior from Tennessee, Xavier Wolf.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Zay back with another video, and today we're gonna go over my indoor season, just an indoor season recap for my freshman year here at the University of Georgia. Without further ado, let's get into it. Starting off, before I go over any meets, need some background information. So my coach left like 2 months before, maybe a month or two before the first meet. He left because he had he got a new coaching job at another school. So went this process of going through trying to figure out, you know what I'm saying, which coach, well, the head coach did all that, but I think they did a really good job of giving us a new jumps coach. So going into the meet, I really didn't trust the coach, really, because, you know, he was new, he hadn't been there long, and I had to really understand what he was, his vision for me and for the jumps group in general, you know. So first me come around, we go to Clemson. I do long and triple jump at Clemson. I got second at both. I jump 767 in long jump. Or 25-2, which was a PR. And triple, I got second, and I jumped 15-47, that's like 50 feet 9, right? 50 feet 9 inches, we got second place. Okay, so then after that meet, we go to Boston. All right, we go to Boston. I'm doing triple jump. I'm doing strictly triple jump at Boston. All right. So we just trying to figure out, like, what would be, you know what I'm saying, best for me to jump as far as possible. So I come up with the idea. I'm like, hey, coach, maybe I should try single arming off the first phase and doing this and this, right? So you say, okay, that's cool. Don't force it, though. Like, don't force the single arm off the first phase and, you know what I'm saying, like, jump something bad. I tried single arming, and I didn't do, I did terrible. I jumped, like, 15, 20 something. Still 50 feet, but I jumped 15, 20 something, and I was like way behind the board. I think it was 15, 27. And I was like way long, like a foot behind the board. I ended up bruising my heels that meet. So, that injury carried throughout the whole indoor season, like the entire indoor season. Just from that meet, and this was in like January. We come back, we trying to get my heels as good as we possibly can get them, you know what I'm saying, rehabbing, doing everything we possibly can to try to, you know what I'm saying, fix my heels and get my heels right. And then we have a meet at Arkansas. Alright, I did both, and this was one of the meets, I think, I forgot what cycle we were in the weight room, but I know my body felt like terrible. I felt horrible. Went out there, jump like 750. No, I think it was still 760. And then went like 1535 or something like that in the triple. Very, like, mediocre. And at this point, I was getting like really frustrated with myself. I was like, what am I doing wrong? You know what I'm saying? Like, what's going on? What do we need to fix? What is like, what needs to click? So, we go back, you know what I'm saying? Go back to the drawing board. And it was something within those next 2 weeks before our next meet, which is at Clemson. We were going all in. We made the focus to go, like, focus in on triple jump. We made that the primary, like, thing. You know what I'm saying? Because at this point, I wasn't in qualifying position, like, at all. Like, the spot I was in for long and triple, I was not getting in nationals or anything. And I was basically projected to kind of go there by my coaches. I wouldn't say anybody else would have ever thought of, you know what I'm saying, me going to nationals. Maybe they saw the potential, but maybe not like indoors, maybe outdoors. But me and my coach, we were like, yeah, we could definitely go indoors. So I was not in the position to go. So then at Clemson, we focused all in on triple jump. And at that meet, something clicked. I had a really, really good jump, and something clicked for me. And that was basically all I needed to, you know what I'm saying, realize, like, this is really good. Like, we're on the right path. So I ended up jumping 15.50. I PR'd again by 3 centimeters. But it was still PR. Further than anything I jumped outdoors. Further than anything I jumped indoors last year. So PR. And taking what I gained from that, we really emphasized that going into SECs, because SECs was coming up, right? SECs was coming up. I think I was positioned like sixth for both. Like, 6 for long, 6 for triple. Get to the meet. At SECs, felt really good. Get to SECs. I equal my PR, which is crazy. Equal my PR at 767. But I had jumps that were 790, that were 790 plus, which were toe rolls, you know, like, where you get all the board, but, like, your toe is, like, you know what I'm saying, like, you're not fouling, but, like, as soon as you, like, lift up, it's a foul. Yeah, I had two of those. Two of those jumps were 790 and I toe rolled. So I got fifth of the whole SECs for long jump. But that mark didn't qualify. But then we get the triple. So my first jump, foul. Right? So we're like, okay. That was a really good jump. My first jump was a really good jump. But I fouled it. Right? Second jump, we come around. I'm a foot behind the board, and I PR'd by a foot. Oh! I was a foot behind the board, but I PR'd by a foot. I jumped 15.82, my second jump. So going into the third jump, I think I was positioned like fourth at the time or something like that, like fourth, fifth at the time, going to the third jump. I jumped 15, like 75 or something like that. And you know what I'm saying? I make it to finals. Okay, so the first jump in finals, I fouled. It was a really good jump, but I fouled it. I don't know what it would have been. It probably would have been like 15, 8 or something like that. The second jump in the finals, I jumped 1598.
As the number 5 NCAA qualifying mark so far through this season. Hit number 4, Marcus dropped
the ball. 1598, and that was like, that's 52.5 and a quarter, right? So, that jump right there, moved me up to third. And then that also qualified me for nationals. They didn't qualify me for nationals. To go to nationals, they take top 16 in each event. And that jump put me in 14th. But we didn't know it at the time. And then the last jump, I jumped 1595, and I ended up getting 4th place at SECs. So coming off SECs, we were like really excited. You know what I'm saying? Like, we were trying to figure out if I got in or not. It was really funny. Everybody was like looking up, and found out I got in. Really, really excited. Really good meet, but my heels, man, my heels were in so much pain throughout the whole meet. So then we go to nationals. Now, mind you, like, I couldn't practice from that Clemson meet. After that Clemson meet, going up to SEC, I couldn't practice. My heels were like shattered, bro. Like, I couldn't get any jumps in at practice. So we were just like lifting and stuff, and trying to do this like as much as we could without hurting my heels. So I really wasn't even getting like triple jump practice. Yeah. And then from SECs to nationals, the same thing. I couldn't jump. Like, my heels were destroyed. So going into nationals, you know, I thought I felt really good. You know what I'm saying? We're warming up. We do the shakeout. I'm feeling really good at shakeout. I'm feeling really good during warm-ups. Then I go to take my first attempt, right? I go to take my first attempt. Boy, I feel so heavy. Oh my goodness, dude. Like, I felt like I had ankle weights on. I felt like I was running with ankle weights on. It was so bad. Like, terrible. Like, terrible. I think my first jump was like 1507. And then I fouled. My second jump. So last time I was like, alright bro, like, I feel terrible, but guess what? We finna jump. Like, this finna be the one. I jump. And I did not make it to the finals. I got 12th at nationals. And the experience and everything was really, really cool up there in Boston. They gave us these boxes, you know what I'm saying? A little, you know, a little present for making nationals. Had a little message on the inside, if I can get it. Had a little message on the inside. Gave us this cup. Gave us that cup. This little charger thing. This little cool charger stack. And a massage ball. Got this little Hyper Ice massage ball. And then they gave us this little metal It's like a participation medal. You see that? Participation medal. You know? I mean, it would have been good if I would have got an actual medal, but it's fine. We're going outdoors. We'll get a national championship medal outdoors. Yeah. That's how that went. Oh, also, fun fact. I was the only one from the team, men and women, who did not place in the top 8 at nationals. I was the only one that didn't place. In individual event, I was the only one. Only one. So, that is gonna burn deep inside of me. That is burning up in me, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, that was indoor season recap. This is recorded on, is today the 20th? I think today is the 20th. But, no, sorry, the 21st. This is being recorded on the 21st of March. And we go to Miami tomorrow, the 22nd, and we compete on the 23rd. So you'll probably be seeing this, like, on the 22nd, maybe the 23rd, I don't know. Whenever I decided to edit this, but yeah, man, I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like, subscribe, and share for more videos like this. I'ma try and do better with vlogging and stuff outdoors. I know. It was really bad. Like, I didn't do anything at all, but I'ma get better. So yeah, like, comment, share, subscribe for more videos like this, and I'm out.